Alright, so this is A Course in Miracles. I'm Anna Kujawa, and we are in the A Course in Miracles workbook, and we are in lesson 329. So, it says, I have already chosen what you will. So, it's speaking here to love, or to Creator, or to God. And it's saying to love, Creator, or God, I've already chosen your will, love. I've already chosen what you want, love. Okay, so it's affirming that. So then it starts with a prayer, and the prayer goes like this. Father, I thought I wandered from your will. Or we could say, love, I thought I wandered from your will or your plan. Love, I thought I defied your will, your plan. Love, I thought that I broke your will's laws. And love, I also thought that I interposed a second will or a second plan more powerful than yours, love or God. Yet what I am in truth is but your will, extended and extending, this I am, and this will never change. As you are one, God or love, so I am one with you, love or God, and this I chose in my creation, where my will became forever one with your will. So what is creation? What is creation? It's where my will became one with love's will. Boop, here I come. That's how creation began, when our will was one with love's will. Creation. Beautiful. Then it says, that choice to share love's will was made for all eternity. That means that choice cannot change and be in opposition to itself. Father, my will is yours. What you want, love, that's what I want too. And so, because of that, because I want what you want, love, because of that, I am safe, and I am untroubled, and I am serene in endless joy. What kind of joy? Endless joy. That sounds nice. Why is it that when my will became one with love's will, that I can now rest safe, untroubled, serene, and endless joy? Because it's your will, love, that it be like that. It's your will, God, it's your will, love, that I experience endless joy. It's your will, God, love, that I do what? That I be safe, that I be untroubled, and that I be serene in endless joy. Because it's your will that it be so. Okay. So then it says, today we will accept our union with each other and our source. Because we have no will apart from love, and all of us are one because love's will is shared by all of us. And through that one will that we share with everyone and everything and the source of love itself, through this one will we share with everything, through that one will we recognize that we are one. And through this one will we find our way at last to God. So it starts off with a prayer, and then it goes on to an affirmation, a decision. Okay. Now, so what I hear in that is that in joining our will to the will of God, which is the will of love, in doing that, that is the way we find our way to endless joy, a sense of safety that the world can never touch, where we can rest safe, untroubled, and serene in endless joy. Okay? That is the secret that A Course in Miracles gives us. You want to experience a safe, serene, untroubled life where you experience joy that only gets better and better and better? Here's the way to do it. You remember that you join your will to love's will. You join your desire to the desire of your creator. So it goes something like this. What you want, love, what you want, God, that's what I want too. That's what it means to join your will to the will of God. According to A Course in Miracles, that's the ultimate secret to ultimate success. Success being endless joy, safety, serenity, peace, and abundance. Okay, well, if that is the secret to ultimate joy, endless joy, then what's the problem? Okay, if that's the answer, that's the answer to having a life that just gets more and more and more joyous as you go. If that's the answer, then what's the problem? The problem is that I think I have my own plans. I think that my plans would be better. I think what I want to happen would be better. I got my own plans, I got my own scripts, I got my own needs, and I think that I can plan for my safety and my happiness better than my creator. That's the problem. And that produces for me a life where it is not just endless joy. It's not just serenity. It's not just an experience of safety. It's something else. So here, the Course in Miracles says it comes down to this. You want to have a happy life? You want to have a life that is just one joy after another after another? You want to have a life that's so good that you just have to hang on for dear life because it's so good? Then there's only one way to have it, and that's every day, in every situation, where you think a decision is there to be made, and you say to yourself, and you remember to choose love's plan. So you thought, I do not know my own best interests. I think I know what I want. I think I know what I would like to happen, but I don't know my own best interests. But what I do know that I want is your plan, love, your plan, God, that's what I want. And so even though I don't know what your will is, I don't know what your plan is, God, I don't know what would make me endlessly happy. All I know is I want it, and so I choose for that. I accept my union with your will, love. I decide for that. Even if I don't know what it is, even if my ego still thinks that I know how to make myself happy better than God. And even though I don't know what God's plan is, what love's will is, that's what I want to come of this situation. That's what I'm asking for. Amen. That's how you choose. That's how you join your will to love's will. And that's how you get something, an outcome that would make you supremely happy that you never in a million years could have planned for yourself. I mean, have you ever noticed when you have experiences that make you supremely happy, you ever noticed that was not your plan? It didn't go your way. You're like, that was the best I could have imagined, and I would have never thought to ask for that. I would have never thought to go talk to that person. I would have never thought that this could happen in this place, in this way. I would have never thought to make it happen like that, or to ask for that even. Ever notice that? The best times in our life tend to be things that we didn't plan. And then the things that we do plan, what usually happens with those?
They fall apart.
They just fall apart, and then we are crying in our beer. The things that are our most fun things are not the things that we planned. But I've noticed for myself, I've learned that if I will start things out by saying, okay, I don't know my own best interest in this situation. All I know is that I want your plans for this trip. I want your plans for this relationship. I want your plans for this job. I don't know what that is. That's fine. I trust you. I trust your love. I trust you have a plan for me. And I ask for that. I ask for that. I have learned in the 30 years of doing the course that that's all that is required for me to have an experience that makes me supremely happy, that has nothing to do with what I thought. And if you add in there, if you add in that prayer, now I think I know what I'd like to happen. Let's say you have something that's on your mind that you think you would really like to have happen. You could say, now, I think I would like it to go like this. I think I would like it to go like this with that person at this time. Okay. You could also say, like, if you can't let go of that, then you could say, that's what I think I want, but I don't know my own best interest. And ultimately, I want your will. And if it be your in accordance with your will that it happened like that, wonderful. But if that thing that I would like to happen, my script, is not in accordance with your plan, then I still want your plan. I still ask for your plan. Now that is a prayer that will guarantee that whatever happens is gonna be better than you could have even dreamed of. Okay? So, then I love it how it says, here's what the ego is. The ego is your belief that you somehow broke God's laws. You wandered from God's will, you defied it, you broke its laws, and that you interposed a will, a plan that was more powerful than God's. You know, I'm upset and scared because I think my ego is more powerful than what my Creator wants for me. That's why I'm scared. If I knew that I can't break love's laws, I can't break love's laws for myself or for the universe. And what is love's laws in the universe? What is love's plan for me? Well, endless joy. Where I am untroubled and I am serene in endless joy. That's love's will. That means that's the universe of the laws. That's what the universe wants to give you. That's how the universe is set up for you. The universe is set up to take care of you, to provide for you, to nurture you, to heal you, to celebrate you. That's what the universe is set up for. Because what is the universe? It's the laws of love. It's the extension of the laws of God, the laws of love. Now, I'm scared because I think I could somehow break those laws and suffer. I think I could break love's laws and set up lack for myself. I think I could break the laws of God and die. That's why I'm suffering. That's why I'm scared. And so when he says, look, you cannot break the laws of love. You can't break the laws of God. That's like, I can't make myself separate. I can't make myself mortal. I can't make myself sinful. I cannot make myself alone. I cannot make myself lack anything that I need for endless joy. But I think I can. I think I can break the laws of love, and that's why I'm scared. So when I let myself be reminded that, hey, there is no will but God's, there is no will but love's, and that's why you can rest untroubled and serene in endless joy, that's the healing. I think I can break the laws of abundance and be broke. I think I can break the laws of love and somehow be rejected or abandoned. I think I can break the laws of love and not have enough. But he's saying you can't. And that's the good news. And your suffering is just your belief that you somehow can defy the laws of love. But the truth is that you were created when you said, yes, 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 the laws of love. That's how you came to be. And you can't take it back. Nice. So if you want to experience all the abundance and the everlasting joy and the everlasting life and the everlasting love and the everlasting companionship and safety and serenity and peace that is the laws of the universe, if you want to experience, it comes from going like what he says. I accept my union with my source. My will and your will are one. Now, that's where it comes from. Thy will be done. Because the only thing that's producing the illusion of lack is because I don't think I want that will. I think I want my own. All right, thoughts or questions about that?
I have a question related to this. What is the Course's interpretation of the term free will?
Good question. Yes.
Because I'm assuming we all have an ego's idea of what free will is.
Yeah.
and they talk about right in the introduction, free will does not mean you get to choose, set the curriculum. Only that you can choose when you take what you... So,
that's right.
I've always struggled over a little bit over the... Mm-hmm. There's some subtlety that's right under my nose.
Perfect question. So, according to the Course, free will is not getting to choose whether love loves you and supports and sustains you. Yeah. You don't get to choose whether love's laws hold or not. The universe is love. Your source is love. Your source loves you, and your source set up a universe that sustains and supplies you forever. Okay, that's the law that he's talking about. And free will doesn't mean I get to go, well, I don't like that law. That's not a law. But my free will, it does mean I can choose to accept that or not. And my free will is that I can choose when I accept reality or not. That's what my free will is for.
So you can choose to create with love or create without love.
Exactly.
And if we miscreate, then we're not creating with
exactly.
Love.
I can either choose to go with the flow of reality and let it hold me up and support me and sustain me and provide for me and make me endlessly happy in every moment, or I can stand in the river and go, get back, get back, get back, I don't deserve it.
I can choose my will, or I can choose God's will. What master do you want?
Exactly. I can either choose my will or God's will. Now, God's will apparently is that we be loved, that we be eternally worthy of the love from which we came, and that we be eternally supplied and supported and healed by that love. But you could, in our will is that we struggle and have to earn it. And maybe if we get it, we have to try to keep it. And that we have to fight to have anything. We have to be competitive to have what we need. That's our will. Let's see, which one will I choose? But that's what the free will is about. Free will is not given us to choose whether reality is true or not. It's just whether you're going to say, yay, thank you, yes, I accept, or no, I'm going to fight the flow. I'm going to stand in the middle of the love current that is the universe, and I'm going to fight it off. I'll do it myself.
If it kills me.
Even if it kills me. And the universe goes, okay, all right. Oh, well, okay, all right. Well, luckily you can't die and you can't ever be without, so just, you know, take your time. You want to suffer and do it by yourself or try to do it alone? Okay, well, we'll wait. That's fine. You know, we are eternal. Love is eternal. So take your time. And as soon as you have decided that you deserve to have love just because of who you are, because that's how your creator is, because your creator is the epitome of a loving parent, when you decide to accept that love, then it'll be here for you.
I think that's great news, actually.
It's totally, it's the best news ever.
You can fight it, but we probably know. I mean, I know when I'm fighting it that I shouldn't be.
Right.
But you just can't sometimes take yourself out of it.
That's exactly right.
But I know that it's always going to be there.
That's
it's
right.
It's like a forgiving parent or whatever.
That's right, exactly.
It's amazing.
That's exactly right.
Okay.
Well, our the only other choice is our own will to nowhere.
To nowhere.
Except
good
pain.
Point.
Our own will
to nowhere.
Exactly. It is, our ego has so thoroughly convinced us that we have to earn love, and we have to earn our livelihood. We have to earn our life. Think about it. I have to earn my livelihood, my life. I have to earn a living. I have to earn love. That's our will. My will is, I'm going to earn it. I'm going to change myself this way, and I'm going to change myself this way, and I'm going to get this person to change, and I'm going to get that person to change, and I'm going to get myself to change and be something better than I am right now. I got to earn it. That's my will. I'm going to be a better earner. In other words, I'm going to work for what and try to earn what is already being showered upon me and is surrounding me forever for no cost, at no cost. But to accept that, boy, that's the work. That's the work. To go, okay, I accept all the love. I accept all the abundance. I accept all the support that my creator has given me because I am my creator's creation. I am my creator's child, period. To let go and accept that. The Course says, yes, it's the easiest thing in all the world, but for the ego, man, that's like takes years. That's the spiritual journey. Because that belief that we have to earn it, fight for it, find it, struggle for it, take it, compete for it, is so deeply ingrained in our consciousness, maybe even our, DNA, that to just accept, oh, okay, I am wholly lovable, wholly supported, wholly sustained, just because I am a child of a loving parent. That's the work of the spiritual path. You know, it's so deeply ingrained that it takes a lot of practice and a lot of willingness to get to the point where you go, okay. All right, I'll let you support me, universe.
It's like such a bad belief that we became attached to, and the whole world believes that way, so that holds it in place.
That's right, exactly. I still really do believe that there's something I need to do to be loved. I still feel like there's something I need to do to have worth and value. I mean, if someone were to say to me, Anna, look, you don't have to do one more damn thing. You don't have to do anything. You are 100% valuable. 100% valuable and worthy to creation. Right now, even if you never moved from this chair or did one single thing for the rest of your life, my ego starts to go, you know, like smoke starts to come out. It's like, nuh-uh. Well, I get that in theory, but I do need to go publish my book. And I do need to make sure that I do this before I die. And I do need to make sure that, you know, whatever. It's very, that's the work of the spiritual path, is letting go of all those beliefs, one by one, little by little, that tell us that we don't just deserve the will of love for us, which is that we have what? That we have, that we be safe, untroubled, and serene in endless joy.
Because the ego has its own view of enlightenment.
That's exactly right. And every conflict and every struggle is some place in our life where we're saying, no, I need to work for love, or I need to struggle or sacrifice to have something. I need to sacrifice for love. I need to struggle to be sustained. Those are the places where we've made up our own laws as to what we need to give up, or what we need to lose, or how we need to change in order to receive sustenance, supply, love, joy, peace, forever. That's one of those places that we have made up our own laws, where we have to go, okay, you know, in this financial situation, I believe I've got to suffer and sacrifice and struggle in order to have some money and some security. Okay, right now that's not bringing me much peace. I'm scared. And, okay, what does the Course tell me? The Course tells me I am under no laws but God's.
Right.
Okay, then, okay, what is it? In this financial situation where I'm terrified about all the laws I think I need to follow in order to be safe financially, what does that mean? Okay, well, it's like this. In this financial situation, you're under no laws but loves. Okay, say that to yourself. Okay, so you say to yourself, in this situation in which I see myself, let me remember, I'm under no laws but loves. Okay? All right, so then you go, okay, well, what would love's laws be in this situation? What would love say if love saw me in this financial situation? What would love say? Would love say, you better get to work. That's right, you better go get a better job. You better start saving some money. You know, what would love say in this situation? Well, love would say, you are my perfect, precious child. Everything I have is yours. You are entitled to the perfect sustenance and supply that is the universe I created for you. Would you like it? All you have to do is say yes. That's something love might say. That's what the laws of love would say. That's what the laws of love would hold for in this situation. Not, you better, you know, you better suffer and sacrifice in order to have a little that you might, that you could lose any moment. Love says, look, you are worthy, you deserve to be supported, supplied, and sustained just because of who you are. Would you like that? Would you accept that? If you knew that we love you and want to support and supply you and sustain you in whatever way you think you need, would you say yes? That's the kind of stuff love might say in that situation. To which you would say, yes. Hopefully. Yes, even if I don't believe it. even if I still don't believe I deserve everything but nothing. Say, even if I don't believe that I deserve everything just for being myself, I'll still say yes. I'll still say yes. Okay, yes. And that's what this lesson is. It's just getting us to the point where we say, okay, half-heartedly, in our half-hearted, unbelieving, suspicious way. That's all that this lesson is getting us to do. Okay, I choose your will. I say yes to your plan. Even if I'm totally suspicious, don't believe it, don't believe I deserve it, don't believe it's possible, okay, yes, all right, okay, sure. That's all this lesson is getting us to do. And then you step back and you see what happens. And then by what happens, you go, whoa, that's what the Course says. You say yes, okay, in total half-hearted suspicion, disbelief. But you did say yes. You did say, okay, I ask for your will, love. And then what happens after that is what convinces you. Okay? Not these words. It's not these words that convince you. It's what happens after you do that, even when you ask and say yes with total disbelief and suspicion. Then you go, and then what happens? Boom! Supply, what you need comes, whether that's even if that's a plan or another job or whatever you need. There it is, poop. And you didn't have to do anything but say yes. Now, sometimes that comes in the form of a job or a plan or whatever, you know, or through a person who goes, hey, I got a better job for you. So sometimes it does come through. It does come through people, places, and things. But it's the results, it's the things that happen after you do that that convinces you that that's the best plan. That's the best plan that you could ever, ever, ever receive. God's will is God's plan for you. God's will is God's plan by which you can receive the abundance, the love, the serenity, the peace, the endless joy that you are entitled to as a child of God. So God's will is God's plan.
So could you say that that goals of form are fruitless, and the only goal is of essence, or setting the goal of peace, because mm-hmm. that's what you're not having at that
yes,
point.
Yes, that's right.
The goal is peace.
And the goal is to accept God's or love's
right.
will.
And I don't know how to get peace.
Right, exactly. Exactly. The goal is to want love's plan for your day, or your relationship, or your job, or for money, or for safety and security. To want love's plan for just a second more than your plan, your scripts. That's the goal. For one moment I go, okay, love, I'm gonna trust that you love me, have a plan for my happiness, and want to give it to me. And so I'm going to ask for that, even though I don't know what it is. And even though I don't know what it is, I still want that. That's the goal. So the goal isn't for me to make something. The goal is for me to want love's plan for me in this situation.
Add to what you just said, even if I don't recognize it when it shows up.
Yes.
And very, I think that's
good
what's
point.
Going on all the time.
Good point. But if you consciously said, okay, I don't know my own best interest in the situation and love, I'm asking for your plan, your will, even if you don't recognize it when it shows up, what shows up is still markedly better. To the point where even you are like, wow. Okay, that's pretty dramatic there. Right. But very
sometimes
often
that takes faith because your ego's
that's right.
using those results as something that is maybe polarly different than what your expectation
is. Exactly right. And the Course in Miracles says you can't say, love, I ask for your plan for the safety, the peace, and the joy of this situation and relationship. You can't say that or make that prayer and not be answered. That's impossible. The Course says you can't ask for love. You can't ask love for something and not be answered. That doesn't happen. Does it ever happen that you go, love, I need help, help me. And love's like, well, I'm kind of busy, I'll get back to you. That never happens. Now, it is absolutely possible that when love answers you, you don't recognize it. Absolutely possible. Yes, and probable. And probable. But good to know that just asking for God's will, love's plan, will always succeed, meaning you will always be answered. That's good to remember, because then you're on the lookout. Then you're on the lookout. Well, I know I asked, I know I can't be denied, and so I wonder when and where it will show up. I wonder if it has already. So it tunes your awareness to look for it.
Look for signs.
Yeah, it tunes you. Exactly.
I like that.
It wakes you up to look for signs, and that's how you know that you've been answered. You'll recognize the signs. That's how you know. How can you recognize love's plan, love's answer for you? We call it synchronicities. You know, exactly what you needed will show up exactly when you needed it, in a way you could have never planned it for yourself. And you go, see, I asked that prayer, and the next thing I know, that was happening. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's how I've come to recognize the spirit's watch care. That's how I've learned to recognize love's plan for me. How? By the signs, by the synchronicities, by the cues, by the needs that are met exactly when I need them, and in such a way that I could have never figured out myself. I could have never gone, okay, I want it to come through that person at that time in that way for that long. I could have never done that. And so that's how I learned to recognize Spirit's plan, love's plan, that I did ask for.
Sometimes that recognition needs some serious deep faith, because it's not.
Yes.
It's very unexpected.
Yes.
And it's faith in truth and sanity, which were the result.
That's right. And I'm glad you said that, because it does appear that that will require faith beyond you.
Right.
Okay. I ask for love's will. I let go of my own scripts. I let go of my own needs and how to meet them. It does appear to require faith more than you can give. But the Course says, but you won't need faith for long. Because faith, you only need faith in absence of evidence. But it doesn't take long of doing this just a few times to be convinced.
Infinite patience yields immediate results.
Exactly. So you're not going to have faith for long, because when you do that plan and you say, I want your will, I ask for your plan, even though I don't know what it is, even though I think I know what should happen, every time you do that, the results become more and more and more convincing. That really does work. And it works so fast and so profoundly that it rewires your consciousness. It happens so fast, so dramatically, that the next time you are in a jam, you remember that, because it got wired in. The Course in Miracles says you learn best through rewards. We think that we learn better through pain. The Course says you don't. Because what brings you pain, you don't want to remember. So really, every time you work this plan and ask for this plan, you get rewarded beyond your wildest dreams. And then what is rewarding, you want to remember and not forget. And it does a better job of rewiring, retraining the mind.
I want to make sure you have gratitude for those rewards instead of guilt.
Absolutely. Very good point. Yeah, once you say, okay, and you do this is a problem-solving approach. This is the ultimate problem-solving approach. The ultimate. So, what's the ultimate problem-solving approach? You're in a jam, you're experiencing conflict, fear, and you go, I don't know my own best interest, obviously, because look what I got myself into. This is my creation. So apparently I don't want only joy and peace and abundance for myself. But love, I trust you. I trust you know me. I trust you love me. I trust you have a plan for the win-win happiness of all involved. I trust that, and I'm going to ask for that. That's what I'm asking for. Amen. That is the ultimate problem-solving approach. And that is an approach where every single time you use it, you get results. And maybe you don't recognize them, but you won't be not recognizing it for long. You do that enough times, it won't be long at all before you're convinced and don't need faith anymore. Now, I don't need to have faith to say, "Thy will be done in this situation," because I know it works. I don't need faith anymore. I know it works. You know? Now, when I get into a jam, that's the first, I'm like, God, help me, God. Thy will be done. Love, ask for your plan. Love, thy will be done. Ask for your plan. Ask for your answer. I just go to it like that.
Even in the mother load of problems?
Even in the mother load?
Yeah, I mean, where your perception is that you need more faith in those situations.
Yes. Yeah. Well, the Course in Miracles says that the situations that seem the biggest and the hardest, those are the situations or events that I am less willing to apply this problem-solving approach to. I'm still, and so instead of going, hey, in this situation where I just got this diagnosis, I'm asking for your will, love your will. Or this situation in which this person sees themselves, that seems impossible, love. I ask for your plan, I ask for your will in this situation. Now, there are some situations that I'm unwilling to do that.
Yeah, it's like we don't.
And those are the ones that seem impossible.
What's the value you give it to the
incredulous? Exactly. That's exactly right.
Because it's so hard to do it the other way. You know, that it's impossible to do it the other way. You might get some temporary results with something easier.
Yes.
Using the other way, but with something like that, when somebody passes or whatever it is you give value to,
yes,
it's impossible.
Exactly. There are no order of difficulty in miracles, but there appears to me to be some miracles that are harder than others. Because there's some problems I won't do this with first. Mm-hmm. You know, cancer. Oh, can't do that because that doesn't apply to cancer. Mm-hmm. Or that person just died. Okay, that doesn't apply to that.
Right.
You know, and so those problems seem impossible. He said, the Course in Miracles says that's the only reason why some miracles seem bigger or harder or more difficult than others.
It's like we don't fully trust love. We trust it with some things, but we won't trust it with all things. Like,
thank you.
I still want to control this because I don't. You know.
That's right. I still don't trust love and truth for all things.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
And now the Course in Miracles says that one of the biggest things that the ego and the one of the things the ego is first willing to make an exception on is relationships. Does anybody notice that? That's the ego's chief exception. That's the ego's biggest exception. So, you know, I may go through my day, oh, love, that will be done. Oh, I'm love. Oh, love, thy will be done, but then my partner does something I don't like, and then I forget all that. I don't apply that. Of Course in Miracles says the special relationship is the first place that we're willing to make an exception. It's the first place I'll make an exception. Because in this case, in the special relationship, I don't want just love's plan, because I don't know what love is, you know, I don't know what love's plan is. You know, so I will throw out that formula. I won't use that, and then I'll go straight back to what I learned, which is manipulating, guilting, cajoling, controlling, all in the name of love. Okay? Now the second biggest place of exceptions is the body. The body, right? So, you know, that's why those are the problems that seem to loom the biggest in life. Relationships and the body.
I don't want to lose my ability to project my death wish on you.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. I don't want to give up the illusion of control.
Yeah.
I don't. Not yet. I don't want to give up the illusion of control. Because I have so much self-hatred that I think if I give up the illusion of control, then people will just leave me. They'll be like, oh, I don't have to put up with that? Oh, bye. You know, which could happen, truly. You know? But that is what we believe. If I give up the illusion of control, then my self-hatred tells me that nobody would choose to be with me. If I didn't use control, aka guilt, to keep people with me, then they would abandon. They would just be like, oh, I don't have to take that crap. Oh, see you later. Thanks. Thanks for releasing me. So that's why we are so willing to make an exception in the area of relationships. Instead of go, you know what, in this relationship, I just want your plan, love, and I don't know what that is. I don't know what it is. You may have a plan that they'd be with somebody else. I don't know. But I do trust that you love me and have a plan for my happiness that will be endless. And so I ask for that, and I'm going to stick with that, and I'm going to wait till I see the signs of that, instead of sit here and try to make up a plan for how to get them to change or how to keep them. Now that's a plan, that's a prayer, that's the application of this to relationships. And then using this in relationship to the body. You know, love, I don't know what your plan is for me in this body. I don't. I see what mine is, and I don't like that. It hurts. And so I'm asking for your plan for this body, for my body, where it should be, what it should be doing, who it should be with. You know, here, I want your plan for this body. I trust that you love me. I trust that you have a plan for this body that would make me endlessly joyous. And I don't know what it is, but all I do know is that's what I want, so that's what I'm asking for. Thy will be done relative to my body. And I'm going to wait to see the signs and the leadings of your plan before I sit here and try to make up one myself. That would be this applied to the body. How about for money? God, love, I trust that you know me and you love me and you would have me no more go without than God would. I know that you would have me know no lack. I know that your will for me is to never suffer lack. And so I ask for your plan for me financially. And I have no idea what that is. I really don't. And I have no idea what that is. I have no idea what your financial plan for me is. But all I do know is that I want your financial plan for me, love. And so that's what I'm asking for. And I'm going to wait in faith to see the signs and the leadings of your plan. And I'm going to trust in that instead of trying to figure out how to get safe and secure. Or get more money. All ways of applying this one answer to what we think of as many different problems, which are not many different problems, but just seem to be, because we're not applying one answer to all of them yet. Once you start applying one answer to all the problems, then you see that they're all the same. As I applied the same answer to that, and I got all the same results, miracles, I wonder what that means. I wonder if that means all my problems were the same. That's what the Course is trying to say. All your problems are the same. And you'll get that when you start applying one answer to all of them. Body, money, health, relationships, global issues, climate change, politics. So that's the goal here.
I think I know the answer. This is the problem.
Say that again.
I think I know the answer, or I know the answer is the problem.
You know the answer is the problem?
Right, well,
answers.
I mean,
no, he's...
I think, you know, I know the, like, I'm saying,
yes.
I know the answer, that's my
that's
problem.
That's right.
But
that's
your
right.
Answer
I
is
think
the problem.
I know the
right.
problem. I think I know the answer. Exactly.
Right.
My answer is always my plan. My will, my plan. My plan for what I'm going to do and what I'm going to say and how it's going to go and how it should go and what you should
right.
do.
And
that's
it's all based on cause and effect.
Exactly.
And which is your path.
That's right. And that's the one problem is my plan, how I think it should go, what I think should happen, and whom I think it should happen through and with. That's the problem.
Because you've always been it that way and you know.
That's a problem because where do you think this problem came from anyway? Did it drop from space? Yeah, that's what we think. We think the problem just showed up, you know, just dropped here. Like, thank you. Thanks a lot. You know, the problem came from our plan, what we thought should happen, how we thought it should go, who we thought it should be with. That's how that problem came to be that we're upset about. And so the answer has to be, I don't know what your plan is, love. I don't know what love's plan is. I don't know what I want. The Course in Miracles says, when you're in conflict, just say this. I forgot what I wanted. I forgot what I wanted. I forgot. I forgot what to ask for. And this is the result of my plan, and hey, love, I'm trusting that you have a better one. Yes, I choose to choose again.
Choose again.
Choose once again. Choose once again. Now for what? Now this time, I'm going to choose for love's plan. Now I'm going to choose to ask for love's plan. I'm going to choose to trust love's plan. I'm going to trust love's love for me. And that's what I'm going to do differently. Now, what could I lose by trying? You know, I already got this. I already came up with that problem.
Stop
what could
choosing
I lose by
out
asking?
Of fear.
Yeah, stop choosing out of fear. Awesome. Beautiful. Well, why don't we stop there for the evening? Yay, yay, guys, for choosing a workbook lesson. We haven't been in the workbook for a long time. So how nice. I love doing the miracle roulette. It guarantees that Spirit's plan will come through. I mean, really.
Yeah.
I mean, that is a very... practical, easy way to guarantee that we get
unauthoritarian.
Yeah, that we get Spirit's plan for the class. And just thinking that I know what's best for everybody who shows up, that's too much pressure. It's too much pressure, especially when I've had a busy day, you know, and I don't have time to go into meditation and ask what's best, you know, for all the class. So, just a couple of announcements. So we started the Transcendental Miracle Meditation class last week, and the Arranger class, and it was so powerful.
Oh,
you guys were there.
Amazing.
Oh my God, I'm still still integrating that. So that is, the next one will be not this Wednesday, but the 24th. So it's 24th. So Wednesday the 24th at 6 p.m. is the Arranger class. And that goes from 6 to 7:15. 7:30 to 9 is the meditation class. So we did the Arranger first because it's so inspiring that it's the perfect prelude to a meditation class. We were just gasping with the grandeur of the section we were reading. Like, all at once, we'd all go, as a group. That was really magical, really beautiful. So thank you.
It was weird that we all opened our eyes at the same time and saw the light flicker.
Yes, that's right.
That's great.
It was, yeah. During the meditation, it was like we were visited. That was beautiful. Yeah. So now we are going to do the integration meditation where we take these ideas and we use them in a visualization meditation process. So.
Thank you.
All right. You're welcome, my dear. And if you would like to learn more about my holistic counseling practice, yes. Miracle Psychotherapeutics, you can go to my website, hannahkujawa.com, and set up a session with me. All right. So now what I want you to do is I want you to close your eyes and take a breath. Just tune into how you feel having heard these ideas so far. All right, now I want you to bring to your awareness something in the last week or so that was stressful for you or frightening for you or painful for you. And I want you to hold that situation, event, or relationship in your awareness, and I want you to look at it. I want you to tune in to the emotions that you have invested it with. Fear, sadness, guilt, depression, etc. Now, I want you to look upon this situation, event, or relationship, and I want you to say, God, love, I think I've wandered from your loving will in this situation, in this relationship. Love, I feel like I have wandered from your plan for me. Love, in this situation or relationship, I feel like I have defied your loving will. I feel like I have broke love's laws. I feel like I broke love somehow. I broke the love and I feel like I wandered from your loving plan. I feel like I somehow broke love's laws in this situation or relationship, and I believe that I have interposed a second will, my will, that's more powerful than yours. I believe that my fear is more powerful than love, than your love in this situation or relationship. And that's why I'm afraid and angry and in despair. And take a breath. We're telling the truth. Now we're telling the truth about this situation, event, or relationship. And then we're going to say to love, we're going to say, love, but what I am in truth is your will, love. What I am in truth is your loving will, your plan. This is what I am, your loving extension, your loving creation. This is what I am. And this will never change. In this situation, love, I think I've made myself unloving and unlovable. But I am your love, extending and extended. This is what I am, only your love, and this will never change. And so I am one with you, love. And that I be only love and one with you forever, love. This is what I chose in my creation, and this is how I was created. What I am cannot change. The loving will that I am cannot change and be in conflict. What I am as love forever cannot change and be in conflict. This is all the things that you're telling yourself. And so we say, love, loving creator, my will is your will. Your will is me as love forever. And my will is your will. And love, because of that, now I am safe. Now I am untroubled and serene. Love, your plan is my plan. Your will is my will, love. I only want your will, love, so that I can be untroubled, safe, and serene, and in endless joy. Your will is my will because you only want me to be in endless joy, serene. And so we say upon this situation, event, or relationship, we pray upon it and we say, love. Your will is that in this situation I only be serene, untroubled, and safe in endless joy. That's your will for me in this situation, and that's all I want too. So thy will be done. Thy will and my will are one. This is how we pray over our situations. And then we say, love, today I accept my union with all of creation and the source of all creation. And we say, love, I have no will apart from yours. I have no plans apart from yours, love. And I'm one with all of creation because we all share your loving will. Your will is love and safety and serenity for all of us. And we say, love, this is the way I'm going to find my way back to peace, back to love. And take a breath. And so we say upon this situation, love, I do not know what your will is. I do not know what your plan is, love. But I trust that you know me, and I trust that you love me, and I trust that you have a plan for my happiness that cannot fail. And so I say, yes, yes, thy will and my will are one. Thy will be done in this place, at this time, for all involved. And then just breathe and bring your awareness back to your calm center. Notice how it feels to apply this problem-solving approach. Notice how it feels to pray this prayer over this situation. Oh, love, thy will be done. Thy will be done. And so it is. Amen. All right, and then bring your awareness back to the room and back to your body. All right. Way to pray.
Thank you.
My friends.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much. That was exactly what I needed. How about you? All right. See you next time I see you.